Good morning, and welcome to today's edition of Stephen Whiteside's Stock Market Timing Television. Each day at this time, Stephen takes a technical look at the markets, including the S&P 500, NASDAQ, gold, crude oil, as well as the most widely held leveraged ETFs. This video is a production of TheUptrend.com and is for information and educational purposes only. The views and opinions expressed in this presentation are those of Stephen Whiteside and should not be considered personal investment advice. Always consult a qualified financial advisor before making any investment decisions. To learn more about the charts featured in this presentation, please visit TheUptrend.com. And now, here is Stephen Whiteside with today's video newsletter.
Good morning. This is Stephen Whiteside with your daily market outlook for Friday, October 16th, 2009. In the pre-market this morning, there's not a lot going on. Futures are basically unchanged. We've got gold and crude oil down slightly in the pre-market. After hours on Thursday, we had Google pop and we had IBM drop, so they've basically canceled each other out. GE's reported this morning. It looked like a loss, but I haven't seen it affect the market much. GE's not a big trader in the pre-market, but it certainly trades in Europe. So we'll have to see how that affects the market on Friday. Starting off this morning, looking at the 60-minute charts. Since we've come off that pressure zone down at the bottom of the screen, we've had four early warning signals and no fall through to the downside so far. Got a nice uptrend line. We're not touching the uptrend line at the moment, so we've got a little bit of breathing room. But we need an hourly close below 1088 on Friday to give us a new intraday sell signal for the S&P 500 cash index. For the NASDAQ 100, similar situation, but we're hugging the uptrend line. So we're seeing a little more weakness relative to the S&P 500 in tech stocks. And we need an hourly close below 1745 on Friday to give us a new intraday sell signal. And weakness in tech stocks, well, if you look at the chips, they're already on an intraday sell signal. So we need an hourly close above 331 on Friday to give us a new intraday buy signal. For gold stocks, they're on a sell signal. We need an hourly close above 178. And looking at the VIX, we need an hourly close above 2250 to give us a new intraday buy signal on Friday. That, of course, should correspond with an intraday sell signal for the S&P 500. Looking at my five favorite stocks, the only one that's weak at the moment is Research in Motion. Apple Computer, we've had a bunch of early warning signals. We have one right now. We need a daily close below 188 on Friday to give us a new daily sell signal. Looking at the CME group, we've got resistance right here, hoping to break out above it. But right now we're looking for a daily close below 292 to give us a new intraday sell signal for the CME group. Moving forward, looking at Google. Now, Google was down yesterday in the daily session and then up in the after hours, so we'll have to see how that turns out. Yesterday's weakness, of course, gave us an early warning signal. To get an official sell signal, we need a daily close below 510 on Friday. We ran up and hit our next price target to the upside, so we have had the opportunity over 2 days to take some money off the table in Google. Looking at Goldman Sachs, daily close below 185 on Friday would give us a new daily sell signal. And Research in Motion, we still need a daily close above 70 to give us a new daily buy signal for Research in Motion on Friday. Taking a look at the major indexes on Friday, for the most part, most things are still doing fairly well. What we've got is we're certainly in the neutral zone for natural gas and the bonds. They've now rolled over. They are on daily sell signals. And of course, we've had long-term weakness in the VIX and the U.S. dollar. Taking a look at the S&P Bank Index, we need a daily close below 129.90 on Friday to give us a new daily sell signal. 1705 on the NASDAQ 100, 1060 on the S&P 500 cash index, $72 on crude oil, 320 on the SOX index, 170 on the XAU for gold stocks, 1039 for the price of gold itself. For copper, we need a daily close below 357. For natural gas, we need a daily close above 480 to give us a new daily buy signal. For bonds, we're looking for a daily close above 134 to close out any short positions and go long. Looking at the VIX, we need a daily close above 25 to give us a buy signal on Friday. And for the U.S. dollar, we're looking for a daily close above 77.70 on Friday to give us a new daily buy signal for the U.S. dollar. Okay, folks, that's all for Friday morning. So far it's quiet, not expecting a lot to happen. Not expecting a lot to happen on the weekly charts that we'll publish this weekend. It looks like all the major trends are going to remain intact as we go into this weekend. So have a great day, have a great weekend, and we'll talk to you again on Monday morning.
That was Stephen Whiteside with today's edition of Stock Market Timing Television. For more information on our charts and services, please visit theuptrend.com.